Hey guys, Gus69 from At Open Mind Brazil. This is the second part of Garage Geek's challenge where he puts me out of my comfort zone again. Check it out. Two weeks ago, I posted my response to Garage Geek's challenge to listen an album for a whole week and make a video with my thoughts about it. And he did the same. It was a fun experience, and he went ahead and challenged me again. So I'm all for it, and I chose for him to review this album, The Human Equation, by the Danish project Ayreon, that I love. He did a great job reviewing that album. If you missed that one he posted last week, I will leave the link here and also in the description, so you can go there and check his take on this album, totally out of his comfort zone. And he picked for me the debut album by Nine Inch Nails, Pretty Hate Machine. Not totally out of my comfort zone, but I have to say that I never listened to this album in its entirety, never. Only these past 2 weeks I've been listening a lot and enjoying a lot. And I must say right off the bat that every time I listen to this album, I liked it even more. But I will get to that. First of all, let's talk a little bit about the artists. Everybody knows Nine Inch Nails. Most of their career was mainly a solo project by Trent Reznor. I know that since 2016 he has like a permanent member in the band, but when he started he couldn't find musicians for his project, so he went ahead as a solo endeavor. He is an American musician and singer, songwriter, of course, from Cleveland or Ohio, and created this project in 88. So before the Nine Inch Nails project, he was in a couple, I think three bands he was in, like a synth pop bands. And then he was working in a studio, like a handmaid, as a janitor of sorts. And every time that in the hours that the studio was not being used, he would trade his service to use the down hours of the studio for himself. So he started creating his music. And I must say that the style that he does is pretty unique. Was very influential for many, many bands that I end up liking in the late 90s, early 2000s. He kind of helped popularize the industrial music, which was kind of a big thing for me, as I said, in the new millennium, for the industrial metal scene. But he was influenced for many, many artists, different artists and genres. I know that he loved Prince, Gary Newman, Skinny Puppy, Public Enemy, all those synth pop bands. It was influential for him to create his music. Bands like Bauhaus, Joy Division, Depeche Mode, and even New Order, because I got two or three songs in this album that reminds me the New Order phase, that I was not into that kind of music, but as a teenager I was listening friends, and when we went out and this kind of music was playing, and kind of know that, but I didn't listen to Nine Inch Nails in that period. Only many years later, when I probably watched some of his videos on MTV, and also in movie soundtracks like these ones that I have, Lost Highway and Natural Born Killers. So I know that he produced some movie soundtracks, also for TV. He did some work, not just by himself, but also with the guy that is now a permanent member of the Nine Inch Nails since 6 years ago. Let's go back to 88, when he created this project, and 1 year later he released his first album, Pretty Hate Machine. And this title sums up very well what the main theme of the lyrics that he talks about in this album, that goes around many love disappointments. He talks about sex, sometimes as a metaphor for drugs, and also about God, religion. But I think that he was trying to get rid of those emotions, that despair that he always felt on his relationships. So let's talk a little bit about the album itself. It was released in October 89, so 33 years ago. He was only 24 years old. And the best definition for this album is synth-driven electronic songs blended with industrial and rock elements. There are some rock. It doesn't feel like organic because of the use of drum machines, but it's kind of there, some distorted guitars here and there, but mostly what you hear is many bass lines, very groovy at times, and many synths and samplers. I think he used a lot of sounds that he likes. So I read that sometimes he liked to hear the television without paying attention, and some sounds pop up, and he try to emulate those sounds, sometimes re-engineering those sounds, reversing or changing the pitch, sometimes playing guitar, but then distorting it to create something new, even with the drum beats, the whole programming that he does. Sometimes he samples and change, which is very interesting, because on the rap scene, for instance, they just pick some loop and use like that. And for Trent Reznor, he always wanted to make that those samples his own, so he changed something to create his own music. So this is very interesting in his music. So besides singing, he plays most of the instruments, guitar, keyboards, and all the programming of the drum machine, which is the something that I never liked so much, or that much, for that matter, in the synth pop music. I like drums, I like the organic feel, the beat, someone playing, the energy of the drummer in the music. I like that. And when I listen to something programmed, like drums, beats, programmed, it sound kind of not emotional for me. It's something repetitive, or it's good to dance, for instance, but Nine Inch Nails is not for dancing. it's for creating an ambient, most of the time kind of claustrophobic, but puts you in that mood of what he's trying to portray, his feelings, his anger, and he's like put you out of your comfort zone, as he's doing with me right now, Garage Geek. So the lyrics goes pretty well along the ambient that he creates on those songs. So there are 10 tracks on this album. The first two songs are very interesting to my ears, and every time that I listen to this album, those two first songs, they grew a lot on my ears, which are Head Like a Hole. It's kind of electro rock song, drum machine beats, reminds me a little bit of New Order for me. Bass groove excellent, catch chorus, reminds me Ministry a little bit, and interesting post chorus too. In the second track, Terrible Lie, is one of those that he sings about his losing faith in God, has a suffocating atmosphere, not much of a progression, the song goes around and round without getting anywhere, but it's a good song, it's stuck in your mind. It's Terrible Lie, he keeps repeating that, very, very interesting. The next song down in it, another New Order beat for me, where he kind of tried to rap a little bit, probably the Public Enemy influence that he assumes, for me kind of sounds like a Beastie Boys, but he's not a good rapper, no. It's the only song that he does that. He says that this song is very inspired by Skinny Pup, but I don't know much of Skinny Pup at all, so I go for his word. And it has a na-na-na, kind of boring for me, in the end part of the song. And it's about a breakup. He sings a lot of about his disillusion with love relationships. The next song for me is the best one, Sanctified. Great song, great bass groove again. Has a tribal feel, that kind of U2. I think U2 was inspired by Nine Inch Nails on their Ashton Baby, Zoropa pop albums phase, where they got more electronic influences. I don't know. This song reminds me, and there is another song here that also reminds me U2, but U2 was inspired by Nine Inch Nails, in my opinion. And on Sanctified, the only thing that I don't like is electric buzzer that pops up, kind of annoying for me. And again, another self-destructive relationship that he portrays, talking about sex, but I think he kind of has a different meaning. I think he's talking about drugs too. Anyway, great song, Sanctified, for me the best song. And then the album, the rest of songs for me is not as good as the first four songs. Something I Can Never Have has like a voice over keyboards and industrial sound effects on the background, like a breathing machine. Doesn't have like much rhythm, just the voice over keyboards. Next song, Kinda Want To. The interesting about this, I note like a guitar solo improv that also reminds me U2, and this song talks about desire and temptation. Next song is Sin, and again another song that reminds me a little bit of New Order, has a good crescendo. Next song, That's What I Get. He talks about unrequited love again, but very repetitive for my ears. Next song, The Only Time. He keeps repeating, maybe I'm all messed up. And for me, there is a Devo quality on that repetition. He keeps repeating the same line. And this is a song that the band Korn could easily do a cover and it would sound awesome. It has a distorted guitar overdub transitioning to the last track, which is Ring Finger. For me, the last remarkable chorus on the album has some distorted guitars, interesting sound effects, and again, some buzzers and scratches at the end. So, in conclusion, Trent Reznor, he is not a great singer per se. His styles range from whispers to screams. And I must say that he's very convincing while screaming. Meaning perfectly his angry lyrics. Like I said before, the album grows up on every listening, and somehow it got stuck on my head. If I had to rate this album, I would give 7 out of 10 for the solo effort of getting out all his anger and social disappointments as a cathartic experience. So that's my take on Pretty Hate Machine, Trent Reznor. He's almost 60 now, I think he's 57. I don't know how he feels about his lyrics when he was a pretty young boy, or young adult for that matter. But I think he's kind of over all those problems that he was facing on young age, and I hope he now he doesn't have that kind of problems. I think he's well married for many years now, and also he can live well with or without God, because he puts everything that was troubling his mind on that period. And I, to finish this video, I must say that this album doesn't represent well what Nine Inch Nails would become later on. Much more experimental, much more industrial, but it's a good album for a debut. So that's it, my take on the second part of Garage Geek Challenge that he gave to me. And maybe we are kind of planning a three-way challenge with another channel, Tickets, Vinyl Tracks, something. We might do a three-way challenge review. So look for that in probably in a couple weeks. So thanks for watching, and see you next time. Bye-bye.